Quite a locale.
All right, so I don't remember where we are exactly. We've been here beforehand. We are at the Westing Estate. We came here for those baseball cards. But now we're here just to go to the Coast Guard Pier, which is a place that looks like I have it, but I know I don't because it keeps on being like, you haven't discovered this location yet. That's fine. What does the Coast Guard have to do with Eddie Winters, actually? They just happen to be a place that they stopped by and went, well, you kind of related to serving and protecting your country, so we'll leave this stuff here. I'm not sure. I probably should start listening to these Eddie Winter tapes sometime soon, which by sometime soon, I mean probably about now. Especially this 01. Let me read this case notes. Case, Eddie Winter, self-inflicted ghoul criminal kingpin, age 200 plus, offenses too many to count. Location, underground bunker, Andrew Station, sealed with a 10-digit code. Okay, each tape has one piece of the entry code. Cambridge Police Evidence Terminal, best lead for finding other tapes. Alright, so those are the notes from Nick Valentine.
Message to Alexander Strelnikov. My esteemed Mr. Strelnikov, I know someone of your profession values discretion above all else. But I have to honestly say, screw that. I mean, come on. One bullet, halfway across town, and you blew Ron Trevio's head clean off. You, sir, are an artist. Are all the assassins from Russia as good as you? I seriously doubt it. But listen, your secret's safe with me.
And this recording.
Signing off.
Don't worry, Mr. Assassin Man. Your secret's safe with me.
Message to Johnny Montrano. Johnny. You fat, lazy piece of shit. I knew this arrangement was too good to be true. Let's join forces with the North End, huh? Bury the hatchet? Work mutually against a common enemy? Well, you put the nail in that coffin, huh, boyo? What did you have to do, Johnny? Huh? What was your job? Sit in your car, on the corner. Keep your eyes open. If you see a uniform, you get out. Walk down the street, knock on the door, and let the fellas know there's trouble coming. Easy as pie, right? I could have got a 9-year-old from the projects to do it, but no. In the interest of Irish-Italian relations, I give the job to you. So what happens? Nothing. Nothing happens. You sit on your fat ass dribbling cannoli cream onto your third chin. You watch. You watch the uniform blow months planning, all in 2 minutes. Congratulations, Johnny. You got me. You and your pal sure put the screws to old Eddie Winter. You should tell his funny story to your little girl when you tuck her in at night. In that corner bedroom, upstairs, pink wallpaper, little house on Prince Street. Yeah. Eddie Winter, signing off.
That wasn't as nice of a message as the one to the assassin guy. Holy crap. But I guess that is the point he's trying to sell these guys out. By just addressing them directly and then leaving a nice little note for them. Holy crap, buddy. I like his way of insulting the dude. Hey, you Italian, you got the cannoli sauce on you. Still have never seen a cannoli. Still don't really know much about cannoli. Only what I've been told by certain other Italians. Some kind of sweet dessert? Alright, what do we got here? Well, they had an area for evidence too.
Say the word if you want me to take a look at that terminal.
No, I'm good. I want you to be able to like me. Really, man? I went through the hole in the wall. Can't you not use a door? Keep the door closed. Alright, what do we got? Winter holotape. This one was delivered all the other places. We'll just... At this point, I'm just following my mission markers for it. Counter smuggling logs. Tasty lad snack cakes. Wooden toy soldiers. Jangles doll knockoffs. Okay. Dough trafficking logs. 120 units of injectable drug stamped with seal property of Chase R&D. Okay, I'm just trying to figure out the general stories behind these things. So this guy killed a Coast Guard, I think. Ooh. That's another person who was killed and then had bottle caps stuffed in their eyes. Maybe that guy's story is more interesting than any winner's. Alright, now where is the Eddie Winters tape? Is he even in here? Oh, it's upstairs. Okay. Well, I'm gonna have to steal all the ammo and drugs. Because you never have enough of those. Especially if you actually never get the skill upgrade for using them. Because then you can use junky weapons and mod their damage like crazy. I just spam Mentats before a battle and get addicted. And you can keep those addictions permanently afterwards. It would just be super annoying with certain other things. But I guess to be fair about addictions, they might reduce your skills, but they don't do that if you're using the items constantly. So that'd be nice. Increase the time for how long those last, and boom. You get the benefits of having constant addictions and having it mod up and damage your weapons.
Got it.
While still having all the other cool stuff. Like having a higher intelligence for more XP, something I should be doing constantly. There's a book in there. Don't know what it's for, but I need every magazine that I can find. I'm never gonna 100% look for all the magazines because there's a little bit too many. I am not a fan of, like, tiny stat increases. I wish the magazines were a little bit less, but hey, you know what? That means they're a lot of cool art just sitting around. Look at that, the Starlet Sniper. Do 5% damage with scope weapons. Neat. That would have been awesome to have for my sniper.
Not enough value keeping the old CPU sharp
anymore. Hey, Nikki Valentine. I'm gonna give you this gun and you're gonna go pop a cap in the Coast Guard, all right? Here you go, right in your head.
What's the plan?
I don't wanna talk to you. I just wanted to give you the mission and then you go. A silent, actual operation. Hello. Hold up. I'm not trying to do this. Tab! Oh, it's escape. Holy crap, that's 9. I'm looking for 4. I guess that's gonna be the one I get next. Whoops. There's always one weapon there. Always one weapon in these saves that make me not able to just press right, or rather R, on the keyboard. It's my own fault for being such a loot rat, or loot whore, I guess would be a better way to say it. But loot rat's pretty alright too. I just need everything. Except for the things I don't need. Which I guess defeats the point of me saying I need everything. Alright, we definitely have 2, or Eddie Winter tape number 2 and 3, but no 4. Oof.
Message to Robert Cooper. Bobby, we discussed this. You hooking up with your stepsister is your own friggin' business. But you talk in your sleep. Look, maybe you babble about baseball, or sing show tunes. Or, could be you chat about those 3 bodies Colin O'Malley dumped in the sand trap of Arlington Greens. You want to take that chance? I know I don't. Sorry, Robert. The girl's gotta go. Eddie Winter, signing off.
I'm wondering if these people actually ended up hearing this stuff.
Message to Robert Cooper.
Oh, I already heard this one.
Bobby, we just messaged to Robert Cooper. You did good, Bobby. The wife and girl won't be saying anything. No worries. Hell, once those fat life insurance checks start rolling in, Mrs. Montrano will wish her fat slob of a husband had eaten that bullet 5 years ago. As for what happens next, up to you. Beach, sub shop, car yard, doesn't matter where he ends up, I don't give a shit. I just want him in the ground. So, long as Johnny Sr. never finds out what happened to his little meatball, we're set.
Whoa, what?
Signing off.
Hold up. in between tapes one and two.
Message to Robert Cooper. You did good, Bobby.
He got Johnny offed. Oh my God. Eddie Winters moved quick. I mean, we don't know what the days were in between these things, but damn, he makes a tape. Like, hey, Johnny Medrano, you fucked up. Did they try to shoot me? Excuse you. We got that guy killed quick. And then the next one afterwards, I'm trying to figure out the chronological order for these things. I usually assume 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You know, numerical order. But so is the third one just straight up talking about something else?
Message to Sal Bosconi. You and I clearly need to talk about Danvers, about the Montrano mess, about everything. I think we'd both agree that our attempts to improve North-South relations have been a complete failure. Look, I take full responsibility for the behavior of my guys. I expect you to do the same for that moron Montrano. But what happened in Danvers? I hardly know what to say. Your people turned that theater into a slaughterhouse. Those people are dead on your orders, not mine. And for no conceivable reason I can see. So let's meet. Just the two of us. Talk it all out. You name the time and place. Eddie Winter, signing off.
Hold up now. There's something caught there, but I lost my train of thought while I was swimming or waltzing through the water.
To talk about Danvers, about the Montrano mess, about everything. I think we'd both agree that our attempts to improve North-South relations have been a complete failure. Look, I take full responsibility for the behavior of my guys. I expect you to do the same for that moron Montrano. But what happened to
okay,
Danvers?
Now I remember what I was gonna say. Alright. For some reason, the subtitles are completely different. The subtitles say a far more offensive thing. Ow. Oh, hey there, little buddy. The subtitles say a far more offensive thing than what's actually being said. In the tape, Eddie Winter says moron. In subtitles, he says fuckwit. I wanted him to say fuckwit. Okay, alright. I can't block a dog biting me. I suppose that's fine.
Not that it's an option.
Maybe you should make it an option. People will appreciate you more if you can show that you're a hard worker. I mean, I guess other synths wouldn't care. And he doesn't care about other synths. But I care about the synths. They appear to have a personality, even if they actually don't have a personality. I don't know. It can be argued both ways. It can be argued that they have personalities because something is being randomly generated in their heads with their minds. It can also be argued that they don't have personalities because those are just pre-programmed everything. Oh boy. I'm really hoping he doesn't walk into here. Because there are a couple of lasers. More than a couple of lasers. Get that out of here. Okay. We don't have to worry about dying there. Oh, I thought that was a big magazine, but it's not. Hey there, Assaultron. Let's make sure you don't turn on, huh? Yeah! Do I have my shader on? There we go. I'm sitting here wondering, like, my eyes are being blinded by my light again. Oh, that was on already? Alright. Sometimes the radios are just hooked up to everything. Oh, it is? It's connected to Radio Freedom. Nope, we can't have that. We can't have Radio Freedom on. Because it's just gonna be like, hey, Radio Freedom, attention to the Minutemen.
Surprise contact. Engaging.
Somebody is, oh Jesus! Someone has become Jesus, I guess. Oh, this was a little trap thing. I thought it was hooked up to here. Oh, it's hooked up to the computer. God. Well, now we know. No turret this time. Though maybe I should have activated it anyways. You know, XP. Yeah, we got the XP for shooting it. Ow. There are so many traps in this place. What is up with that? Do we get any information? There's a fuckload of terminal or fuckload of tapes. Hobby Club message, March 28th, April 21st.
Enjoyed that last number.
Shut up, Travis. What's going on with this?
Coral, it's me. I know you're in there, so just open up. The boys saw you up here yesterday. Look, they ain't gonna wait, and I ain't gonna wait. We leave in the morning, so just finish playing Hermit and have your ass at camp by sunup. What in the hell's wrong with you? You don't get to vanish like this. I don't care how many booby traps you hide behind, Coral. We're still here. He's your kid, not mine. So you better get your shit together and come find us when you're done with this idiocy.
And then meanwhile, almost an entire month later...
Maybe you figured out something a long time ago and I'm just learning it now. Just wasn't fair, Coral. If not for this kid. Yeah. Sure thing, kiddo. I'm hungry too. And there's nothing for us here. Let's go.
Aww. It's so sad that this box will never be able to find a home. He could never settle down. Also, it's sad that the mother disappeared and abandoned her child. What the hell's up with that? That's, I guess, a pretty important story too. Ah! I don't know what just happened. Did the box explode or something? Okay. Alright, box. Oh, here's something here. That might have been set off by the box. Why me? There's so many traps in this place. Oh, but she gave me jet and stim packs. That's so nice. That's so kind of her to leave things that can heal me after being fucking shot and blown up by her. Not this time. I knew. So the question is, was she abducted? Was she abducted by the Institute? Or did she just die out here in the wasteland? Or was she just kind of hiding because I don't want to take care of a cat, so I'll leave that to my best friend. Suckers. Hopefully it's not the last one because that would make her a bad person. We don't like bad people in the wasteland. What is going on over there? Have I been here before? No, because it isn't marked as known. Okay. Well, I'm gonna take a bunch of anti-radiation meds. That way I can actually walk into that place without having any trouble. I always forget what these things are marked as. Okay, medicine. Probably won't stop all the radiation, but that's fine. As long as it doesn't chunk out half of my health, I'm always happy. Super mutants? Oh boy. I wasn't expecting that. Oh great, they molotoved me. At least there aren't like plasma fire molotovs. Now that would be interesting. And scary to go against. I mean, I guess they have plasma grenades, but that's just not the same thing. Those things don't blow up immediately on you. You have like a moment to react and go, oh, I don't like this grenade next to me. I will run. But with a Molotov, those things are instant. And you're fucked. At least at low levels. I'm amused at how fast that burns through my core. If you just, like, look at the bottom where the core energy is, holy crap. One full flight is just ridiculous. Alright, this is it, Eddie. Nick. We're gonna get the last holotape. I might as well listen to another holotape while we're down here.
Message to Charlotte Wen. My dear Miss Wen, I hope you're well. After our little joint venture this past May, you should be. If memory serves correctly, that pallet of buff out earned you a small fortune, and Wu Li 8 years in a state correctional facility. So I got to thinking, why not do it again? We both love the same things, money, and destroying people who get in our way. Together we'll outmaneuver them all. Boston will be ours for the taking. Let them play checkers. We'll play chess. Eddie Winter, signing off.
Just because chess is more complex than checkers doesn't really mean much. Oh, hello. But I say that because, you know, maybe things can get intense with checkers. I haven't played a game of checkers in many, many years, and I've never played a game of chess because I don't know the fucking rules of chess. Because it kind of requires a lot of memorization, like, oh, what does the horse do? Oh, it can move in an L pattern, but not in this particular circumstance. Ugh. Not a fan of that. But speaking of rad stags, do I have any grilled rad stags? I don't. Fine, I'll just use drugs. I want to be able to run, and I don't want to bother dropping everything at the moment. How many red rockets am I going to run into out here? There's at least like 10 red rockets around the wasteland. Maybe not, but there's at least 7. Or 5. There's a lot of them. I just don't know how many exactly, and I don't want to, like, make too hardcore of a statement of, well, there's at least 50 of them, man! Oh, what do you mean there's only 30? Shit, I was wrong. But I've been wrong about less. I could have sworn I'd been here, but I guess not. This is the northern side. Or not? No. This isn't connected to Fort Hagen at all. This is that place I was gonna check out before. Yeah, alright. Nikki, bring me over to Natick. Natick Banks. And the police station right across the street from it. So they can bust down on corruption. The hell are you doing? Were you trying to escape during the apocalypse? And they beat you down and all died with you? And this guy just kind of flopped over dead, like, well, shit. He could have been his chair. He didn't have to be like this. Oh, boy. This is peculiar of a situation. Okay. We want to just try to go from the top. I'm imagining, yeah, it'd be up here. Oh, this is just the terminal saying where it is. Okay. Holotape 4 is in Natick Evidence Cabinet GN1, so it's here. It's here. One key recovered from gully with remains of a tractor. Okay, Mr. Mistral. What about you, Reed? One tire iron recovered from sea, no prints found. One bag containing shattered glass recovered from home exterior. One set of fingerprints lifted from Mr. Reed's safe. Print set matches those in file. Case. Reed fraud. So Reed was pretending to break and enter. Oh, wow, okay. And maybe there was a little bit more to that, but ooh. Some of these people were really scummy, but I guess that just all simulates the world. Some people try to do some crazy things to try and game the system. I understand. Sometimes it's just hard trying to make a living out there in the world. Especially with fusion cores, or robots that take care of your every whim. Oof. Life is rough. There you go, Nikki. I got every single winter tape. And I have to listen to all of them before I talk to you.
Reservations are for 7 at the Cornerstone Grill. Don't worry, I'll make sure Arthur's on his best behavior. No stabbing the waiter for a fucked up drink order, like what happened in Charlestown. Even though the prick deserved it. Love you.
He's talking to his girl.
Winter, signing off.
I just started catching it. He just said reservation at 7, and that was his little hint as to what the number is. One of the numbers.
Charlotte Wen. My dear Miss Wen, I hope you're well. After our little
trip
this past May, you should be.
Won't be bothering anybody now.
I think we're going to have to restart that, because I couldn't hear it over the sound of the death claw coming out to murder me. You guys have a fucking pet death claw just chilling out in the front gates? That reminds me of a little dog I always constantly see whenever I drive by a place. They have an open fence, the dog never leaves, he's probably been trained to never leave. And he just sits there, he looks at everybody, and you're like, oh god, he's gonna run out and try to get me? Nope, he's just gonna bark at me like the grouchy old German Shepherd he is. Roar. That was that Deathclaw, except it finally escaped. The German Shepherd finally escaped to kill me. The horror. Oh my god, I only have 25 bullets on my Overseer rifle. Oh wow. I need to make more. I could buy more, but that'll take slightly more time. Whereas I can just use up a bunch of resources. Let me see. I think I have 2 points. I do. What do I want to put those 2 points into? I could put it into melee attacks. Alright, let's see. Where's the melee? 20% more melee damage. And what about this? Channel your chi to unleash devastating fury. Punching attacks. No, I'm good. I'm definitely never gonna use punching attacks. As fun as it would be to, like, absolutely devastate things with punching, I'm good. I was gonna build up towards, like, sneaking, but now I'm not so interested in it at the moment. Or many of these things, honestly. Well, I probably shouldn't build towards melee damage just because, let's be honest, my melee attacks at the moment are pretty much just for jokesy fun. I don't need to do that. But I don't need to do other things either, jeez. When over-encumbered, you can fast travel. This would be nice. Maybe I'll finally get this, so that way, if I'm ever over-encumbered out in the wasteland, I can just go straight back. But usually I just take drugs, then go straight back and slowly walk. Crap. I hate skill points. Damn them all. I just don't know what I want. I could put things down in this luck tree because, it's pretty low. It's actually the lowest skill I have. See? It goes all the way up here, whereas everything else is about here. Or here. I've actually tried out Vans, and it looks okay. It basically puts out like this green hovering misty line towards your objective. It's not something I actually need because obviously you have the compass down below you, but I guess that could be cool for someone who's obviously like level one. You're like, where the fuck is shit? And maybe even for objectives too, if you're getting really, really lost. Alright, I'm just gonna close that out. I have no idea what the hell I want.
Message to Buster Conley. Nice piece you did on the monorail construction project. Heaven's Highway? Devil's Doing? Cute. But I think you give organized crime too much credit. The various Boston families coming together to fund a public works project? Please. Clearly you never sat down to dinner with these guys. They can barely agree on an appetizer.
That's it.
Buddy jumping a pickup. You did get one thing right, though. Safety Inspector Alice Lansky was killed. They'll never find her. Because there's nothing left.
Well, he's got the threat still.
Message to Rodrigo Palomar. Okay, my friend. I thought about it. And I've reached a decision on the Fallon's job. Your cut is exactly what you deserve. $0. Zilch. You heard me right. You get nothing. Yes, you cracked the safe. And yes, we got the diamonds. But you also tripped the alarm. Mackie got pinched, and that's entirely your fault. Now, when he gets out, Mackie's gonna want your head on a platter. I'm gonna give him your share instead. I see you getting off easy. Eddie Winter, signing off. Message to Rodrigo Palomar. Okay, my friend. I thought about it. And I've reached a decision on the Fallon's job. Message to Claire Pazinski. Time to start thinking about a vacation. How does 6 weeks in Ireland sound to you? Dublin, Galway Bay, Waterford. Maybe a week in that little bed and breakfast in Kilkenny. And don't worry. We don't have to take my cousin Stephen with us. Let him get out of the country on his own. I told him to threaten that cop. Not blast him in the face with a shotgun. He can rot in that abandoned fishery down in Union Wharf for all I care. Love you.
Someone died. Once again.
Eddie Winter, signing off.
I think I caught the one number for that one. Hold up. I keep on forgetting to pay attention for numbers. He said six for this one. How did 6 weeks in Ireland sound for you? Yeah, okay. Well, we can always talk to Nick. He's probably going to put everything together there. Okay, I'm not sitting down for one terminal. Or I'm not getting out of the power armor for one terminal. Let's get this safe like this. The hard way with hard work.